In Are You Surprised news submitted by Yo Mama's Mama.
Hey.
My grandma.
Yo Mama jokes are coming back.
Really?
Yeah, it's a meme.
Yeah, Nikki always tells me my mom this, my mom that, whatever.
She does.
Panera Bread fired an employee after she posted a video exposing how the mac and cheese is made.
What?
Is it made by elves twerking and stuff?
How'd you know? When it's like, are you surprised? Is it like she just said some obvious shit like, it's made with dairy from cows and from noodles? What?
I'm gonna guess they have the cup, it's frozen, she takes off the thing and then puts it in the microwave.
Mmm.
Wait. Yeah, so this video was posted on TikTok with the caption, exposing Panera. And
if you're an employee, you can't be doing shit like that, though.
Unless it's not really exposing, it's like actually promoting. What did she do? I want to know.
I want to know.
Like if it was satire, you know, like
yeah, I love
exposed.
TikToks.
Look how much you could save right now.
Do you go on the TikToks? Everyone keeps telling me to go on the TikToks.
We should all go on the TikToks.
Don't listen to that man. He doesn't know what he's talking about.
What?
Unsuccessful as Gary
Vee. Now she's slamming Gary Vee.
Hey, Gary Vee. I hate this man.
You hate him, really?
Yeah, I hate him.
Well, let's talk about that. Fucking yeah,
why do you hate him?
Because
he's everywhere?
Because I think he gives not the best advice. And I, in my opinion, I see quality winning over quantity, and I don't think he necessarily.
Do you know what
that
format you are on?
What's that mean?
JK News?
Oh.
Quantity over quality and maybe quality. Not the best advice.
We do quality and quantity.
Yeah, but you're not reposting JK News on TikTok, Instagram, and
but
like Joe repurposing everything.
Because I know what you're talking
this
about.
This is a different format.
What he does is he gets one long speech and then he chops it up and then he posts that all over the place.
I was joking because the way she said it was like, oh, I hate him because he gives not the best advice and he does quantity over quality.
Exactly what you guys are doing. Terrible. Terrible. But he, for people who are just starting their business, he says, you should be making 100 pieces of content a day. And I'm like, that's, you should be building a business and like, you can't be on Instagram and TikTok, especially not TikTok. But what the fuck do I know?
Yeah.
I think the demographic too though, cause like you can be on TikTok posting 100 pieces of content a day if you're 15 years old, you got nothing else to do in your life, you know, like, and you could be making money and brand deals and getting whatever, but.
I went to one of his dinners and I saw him speak, did do a keynote and stuff like that. It was pretty interesting cause he does the Q&A during dinner, and the dinners are like, I think it's like a grand or some shit, but the people that are there are different from the people that are at the keynote. So the keynote might be like a big corporate group that's like mid to lower level that are paying like a couple hundred bucks or maybe beginners, right? But then the dinners, you have people that are more, they run businesses or they have money. So that's why the questions are more in depth. And the way that he actually makes money is that and consulting to big corporations. But when he does those speeches, I think they're for people that are lazy as fuck and have no clue what to do. So it's what I found out is that the way he's talking depends on who the audience is at the moment. Because he wasn't saying the same shit during the dinner. And I was like, oh, this is different.
Well, okay, I watched an interview with him. Any interview that he does, he is constantly interrupting the person. And he's there to interview them, right? Like, I watched the interview with him and Paige Hathaway because I wanted to understand how she's made a career for herself.
Oh, he just steamrolls and talks all fucking day.
And he told her she needs to be a business coach. And I was like, why would you tell Paige Hathaway, the sweetheart of Fitspo Instagram models, that? Like, that's the worst advice I've ever heard. Thankfully, she didn't do it because she probably just makes so much more money doing what she does.
Yeah.
And like, would I pay Paige Hathaway to teach me to do that? Probably not. Cause it's Paige Hathaway, like, I'm never gonna be her. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I do get what you're saying though. I think, you're right, where he doesn't take the time to dissect each individual and what's best for them. He has this brainstorm rant where he would just go off and just talk. And in between, there might be like things that are like, oh, that's gold. But if you take everything like the Bible, as he says, because he speaks with so much conviction,
yes,
you'll be like, damn, you might make some mistakes there.
Yeah. Because when I speak to someone, I'm always like, maybe you want to think about this, or you could also do this, and try to give perspective that you can either take or leave, where he's like, no, this is what you need to do in everything. Yeah. And I'm like, well, how do I know? Also, you passed up on Uber, so like, am I supposed to be listening to you for my investment strategies when you made mistakes?
And also, like, how's the mac and cheese made?
True.
So,
anyway, I hate Gary Vee, just so everybody knows.
Well, that was interesting to hear your thoughts.
Yeah, it is.
Here's the TikTok Panera Bread thing.
Bruh, look at this dude. Wait till you see the. No.
Does he sound like Tyson?
No.
From another video.
Oh man.
His reaction.
It's like they grabbed audio from a different meme.
This TikTok.
Yeah, because it's TikTok, yeah.
I'm like, that guy doesn't sound very white. But his hands are.
So this.
Because you can see the long fingernail.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then plus at the end, she's.
She got fired for that?
She got fired.
Wait, why?
Her intention?
Well, I mean, it doesn't look very appetizing. Like, it kind of turned me off. Well, and I'm like, ugh.
She
but
just got that.
Subway, they do it right in front of you. They, like, warm the chicken in the microwave and then, like.
You want your bread toasted? I'll put it in the microwave right now.
I don't need that Subway.
So maybe that was like a sous vide thing, and then they cut it, and then they cut it open, and they dumped
it. I think
sous vide.
It's frozen.
It's very classy. I think she probably got fired because of her intention, I feel like.
Yeah,
like,
the voiceover made it.
Because like if she's, her intention is to out the company, even though that's just policy, and I feel like if I was hiring her, I'd feel like there's some sense of betrayal there. Like, what are you trying to do to me?
Yeah, you're not proud to be here.
Yeah, yeah. Like, get out of here. Yeah. Why are you trying to out me in some way?
Oh,
yeah,
so she's like trolling her own company.
Yeah.
She ended up tweeting, LOL, I lost my job for this. And so a spokesperson for Panera Bread confirmed that they confirmed the video's authenticity.
That's tight. Yeah, we do that. We sous vide all our shit.
Yeah, but they declined to comment on personal matters, and they defended the way that they prepare mac and cheese, and they said that it is a patently Panera product made off-site with our proprietary recipe developed by our chefs. It is shipped frozen by our bakery cafes. This allows us to avoid using preservatives which do not meet our clean standards.
And it's not like
and it's vacuum bread. Sealed, so it's not gonna be contaminated with shit after it leaves the the main hub.
I think like, I guess like the Panera like image, it's like it's a restaurant.
It's not though, cause it,
I
so
know
it's you or they don't even serve you. You order at a counter, you know, so it's not even.
I guess like the dish
it's
part.
It's like Denny's is here, Panera Bread is here. I mean, the food quality is better, but it's Denny's is an actual restaurant.
Yeah.
So they're making food.
Denny's food tastes like shit compared to Panera Bread.
So that's what I'm saying. It's Panera Bread is, they're acting like Panera Bread is a place that you get served and it's like high quality food, but Panera Bread is just a counter.
For sure.
So I'm like, why are they so upset or like surprised?
Yeah, and then that's why people are like, well, I knew Panera was just a cafeteria food and like all this stuff, or hospital food, and this proves it.
Yeah, it's like corner bakeries. You go order and then they give you the food.
Do they expect like a freaking middle-aged lady that's cooking up some shit from 5 a.m. and like, what do they expect?
Probably thought it was like an 8-cheese masterpiece.
Oh my God, that's stupid.
Yeah, and then someone said, I don't get what she's exposing. Did people really think there was a chef hanging out in the kitchen?
Exactly.
Yeah. Panera Bread making their mac and cheese? This is literally how every fast food joint operates. Don't be fooled.
Yep.
Yeah, I'd rather have that than fucking powdered cheese and, you know, like the instant one. That's crazy. Wait, so people don't know that this is normal? And then they feel exposed?
Also, like TikTok, a lot of younger people are on it. So maybe they just don't know that that's how restaurants, or especially like Panera Bread and like fast food restaurants are. And then that's why it went viral, because they were like, what? It's like this.
It went viral?
Mm-hmm.
Anything goes viral on TikTok.
Oh man, I need to get on TikTok.
Yeah.
Are you on TikTok?
Just scrolling. I tried, but I only got 38 views.
I thought everything goes viral.
Yeah. No.
What an ass.
But like, did you do a dance?
No, I didn't do a dance.
That's
I tried to do fitness stuff on TikTok, but I don't know.
Did you show more butt?
Butt works.
Did you show more butt?
Yeah.
And it's got a bounce.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it's all about like bouncing. The hashtags or like whatever their challenges are.
Yeah.
You know, like if a certain track is trending,
so
then
it's
you.
It's like Vine?
Yeah.
Like how Vine would have their.
Yeah.
It's thing. Exactly like that and like Musical.ly.
Do you know my favorite TikTok that I've seen? It was the one where the kitty, where it's like the do 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 do, the Mr. Sandman one.
Oh, yeah.
And you see like the kitty, and it was like, I forgot how many, like, screens or whatever. That's been like my most favorite TikTok.
I think sent it to us.
Oh yeah. That's fucking cute.
Have you seen the wait a minute, miss the post?
Oh yeah, that one's fucking good too. So it's like that song is playing in the back and then you just see photos, like for the one that I saw was like my dad, and it's like this really like handsome looking man. And it's just a whole bunch of photos of his dad, and then it switches over to a different part of the song, and then it says the man my mom cheated on him with, and it's like this ugly ass like really like downgrade version of the husband, and then it's just like,
so it's just a bunch of like people making TikToks where they have an attractive parent that gets cheated on with the uglier like Sancho or Sancha. Yeah,
that was pretty funny. Or it's not just cheated, but then it's like remarried or something.
Yeah,
they married, they pretty much downgrade.
I see.
Yeah. But that was a pretty funny compilation.
But I still have never downloaded this app. I just see it on Twitter. So on TikTok.
So you see reposts.
I do. Yeah, I've never seen
it. It's pretty fun. But sometimes I'll be in my office, like on TikTok, and then Ryan will come in and into my office, and I'll just like throw my phone because I'll be like,
you're
networking. I'm not watching. I'm embarrassed about how much I'm on TikTok. Because it can suck you in.
Oh, good thing.
But it's me just watching all these 16-year-olds doing like stupid dances. They're not even good dances.
But you're hooked.
Yes, I don't know why. It's so good.
It's a 16-year-old, huh?
That's funny.
Maybe. No, no.
You heard it here first, folks.
Man. She loves 16-year-olds and she hates Gary Vee.
Oh, man.
Meg can't.
And Panera Bread sous vides all their stuff.